A useful galvanic cell can be constructed by using zinc and copper. The anode is a zinc bar placed into a zinc sulfate solution. And the cathode is a copper bar placed into a copper 2 sulfate solution. The two solutions are connected by a porous sodium chloride salt bridge that prevents the two solutions from mixing but allows ions to migrate. Attaching a cell shows that electrons flow from zinc to copper. Because zinc is a more active metal than copper, it is more likely to lose electrons. For this reason, the zinc bar is oxidized, producing a zinc ion and 2 electrons per zinc atom. The copper ions in solution gain 2 electrons and are reduced to copper metal. As the reaction continues, excess positive zinc ions build up in the zinc solution. At the same time, the loss of copper ions from the copper sulfate solution creates an excess of negative sulfate ions. Positive sodium ions migrate into the copper sulfate solution from the salt bridge, while negative chloride ions migrate from the salt bridge to the zinc solution and maintain neutrality of the solutions. The reaction stops when the zinc bar or copper ions are depleted. The overall cell reaction can be written like this.
See here, this is the galvanic cell diagram. What is that? Galvanic cell diagram. Right. Now here to see. Look at here, zinc rod placed into the, this is a zinc rod now, placed into the zinc sulfate. Copper rod placed into the copper sulfate. Now here is a zinc rod is a anode. This copper rod is a cathode. So I denoted here anode, which hand side? Left hand side. Anode, left hand side. Anode, left hand side. Cathode, right hand side. This is the cathode, this is the left. Right hand side. This is the left hand side. So this is right hand now. Right hand now. Right. So cathode, right hand side. Here is anode, left hand side. So look at here. Zinc rod immersed in a zinc sulfate and copper dipped in a copper sulfate. So now these two beakers separated with the porous NaCl or KCl or NO3 of salt beads. Okay. Right now, it is to prevent the intermixing of, prevent the mixing of these both the solution. Okay, right. When you connect the, these two electrodes, when you connect the anode electrode, cathode electrode, now it show the electron flow from the, it show the electron flow from the anode to cathode. It show the electrons flow from the anode to cathode. So see here, so when, because of here zinc rod is the very active than the copper, zinc rod is a very active, means it is easily to lose of electrons. Now how it is lose? Zn plus 2 is formed when you remove from the when you remove its 2 electrons, they form the Zn plus 2 ion, and these electrons are moved towards cathode side. So finally, to observe here the copper plus 2 ions gain of electrons to form the copper on the surface of the cathode, on the surface of the cathode, that is a copper rod. So here copper is deposited on the surface of copper. Here zinc rod, they lose of electrons, and the Zn plus 2 ions are excess build in the zinc sulfate. Here copper's SO4 minus ions are created in the SO4. The more created in the SO4 ions in the copper sulfate solution. So simply see here, Zn plus 2 ions are increases in the Zn SO4 solution. Here SO4 minus ions are increases. So copper ions are come to the cathode. So look at here, this like copper ions are come to the cathode and they take the electron forming copper. Now here electrons lose, that electrons move towards the cathode. Here Zn plus 2 ions, Zn plus 2 ions increases, means here more Zn plus 2 ions are build up in this Zn SO4 solution. Here SO4 minus anions are build up in right hand side of this copper sulfate solution. So it is time the chlorine ions, which are the chlorine ions, move towards the zinc sulfate solution, and here the sodium ions move towards the copper sulfate solution. From the salt beach, chlorine ions move towards zinc sulfate, sodium ions move towards the copper sulfate. So they maintain the neutrality in the zinc sulfate and copper sulfate. They maintain the neutrality by the salt beach of ions. Okay, right. See here, left hand side. Here the left hand side, no anode. So the two off-cell reactions. I given here the one reaction, anode, lose of electron. So by the zinc rod, they lose of two electrons. Zinc plus two forming two electrons. At the cathode off cell, this is a cathode off cell. I written right hand side, okay, right hand side, left hand side, this one gaining of electron, copper ions are gain of electron forming copper on the surface of the copper rod. So here increase SO4 minus, here increase Zn plus 2 ions. These Zn plus 2 ions neutralized by the chlorine, these SO4 minus neutralized by the Na, like to the Na to SO4 form. Right, next one, here this is a copper, this is the cathode of reaction, gaining of electron, copper plus 2 plus 2 electron forming copper. So final I given net reaction from the anode and cathode. Zn is converted into Zn plus 2 plus 2 electron, and the copper taking these 2 electron forming copper. So see a final reaction, Zn plus Cu plus 2, Zn plus Cu plus 2, Zn plus 2 plus Cu. What is form? Zn plus Cu plus 2 gives rise to Zn plus 2 plus Cu. So the zinc is lose of 2 electron, the copper is taken, now zinc plus 2 and copper forming. So this is the net reaction. Now look at here, zinc is the more reactive than the copper. Okay, so this is, remember, zinc is the more reactive, keep it in mind, the zinc is more reactive than the copper. So zinc easily lose electron. Okay, right, next one is the zinc is more reducing agent. So zinc is the more reducing agent than the copper. So copper is more oxidizing agent, copper is the more oxidizing agent than the zinc. So what is the reducing agent? Electron donor is called the reducing agent. Electron donor, reducing agent is called the electron donor. Oxidizing agent means electron acceptor. Electron acceptor is called the oxidizing agent. Clear? Now if to see here, so small difference, that one oxidation is called the loss of electron. What is the oxidizing agent? Oxidizing agent is called the electron acceptor. What is that? Electron acceptor. So remember, now keep it in this these two points in the mind. Oxidation, loss of electron. Oxidizing agent is electron acceptor. Now next one, reduction. Reduction means gain of electron, gain of electron. Now what is reducing agent? Reducing agent. So reducing agent means this is gain of electron. Now reducing agent is the electron donor, is the reducing agent. Electron acceptor is the oxidizing agent. So don't confuse, oxidizing agent is the electron acceptor, reducing agent is the electron donor. Oxidation is the loss of electron, reduction is the gain of electron. So I hope you understand this topic. The next page, representation of galvanic cell as per the IUPAC convention. So here keep anode or oxidation electrode in left hand side, anode left hand side, cathode or reduction in right hand side. We said right hand side RHS. The electrode can be represented by the single vertical line. So here electrode is represented by the single vertical line. So look at here, here is a zinc rod, this is the vertical line is indicating electrode. Now here to see double vertical line are represent salt beach. This double line is the salt beach, this single vertical line is the electrode. So when you write the when you show the representation of galvanic cell, so must be anode, it is anode must be in the place of which side? Left hand side. Which side? Left hand side. Anode must be kept in left hand side, and next cathode must be right hand side. Right hand side. So here anode reaction loss of electron, here cathode gain of electron. So Zn is converted to Zn plus 2 and copper plus 2 converted to copper. So this is the cell representation. Okay, great, thank you.